Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory. This is kind of the first official day that we are working on the space roadster. I think that's what we're going to call it in earnest. So I wanted to run by a few things that I think are important when you are doing this build or starting a build like this, and that is of course to get all the parts ready, modified, everything that you think is going to make your life easier during the building process. To do it, we learned this way back, even when you're doing shiny, of course, to glue the engine halves together and then add some of the other parts, just because oftentimes those parts are part of the unit and the block, and with an airbrush it doesn't really matter. Most people think, oh, with the airbrush I can't paint this one color and that another color. That's not true. You could get in there and really do some amazing detail work with the airbrush, but that's another, you know, that's another video, another discussion. So a couple of things that immediately pop into your mind, and that is, of course, if this build is going to have the so-called anti-gravity boosters, the mechanism by which the viewer begins to believe that it has potential to hover and or float and or fly. Basically the technology that brought us the Warthog, right, and some other, and the Harrier jump jet and all of that, with some kinds of engines that can do that. They can swivel and pivot and tilt and get you the boost you need. So anyway, to make a long story short, the idea here is, how do I stay in scale and still have a model that looks good in scale and not over the top? And of course, that is to sort of work with the idea that most cars come with wheels and rims, right? So we've gotten in the last few builds now, we've gotten into the habit of building and modifying, of course, the boosters right out of the wheel parts, just so that they, you know, they take on a little bit of meatiness that the vehicle would have with the tires on, etc., right? But we're not using rubber tires on this, we're using metal. So we are going with these wheel parts that often will come from the kit, or you have to raid another kit or your parts box. And so, again, when you're working with raw and naked styrene, whatever thingy-me-jiggies you're going to add to them, this is a perfect time to do it. So I've already added my couple of tube intakes here for, you know, the whatever it is that the electricity or power or fumes or hydraulics or whatever the hell it is will go in there. So these are the ones for the rear. Okay, and we are using the details appropriate, I think, for a you know, a roadster like this. So we are, you know, making it look like a kind of a fan, a kind of a booster. That's basically the detail there. It's all in the design. And then, of course, the same thing for the front. And, of course, the front are going to have, they're going to be slightly smaller, but they are still going to be in scale. And so we like that. And we've added a few little tricks so that when we put the axles on there, we're not going to have any problem gluing them, because in fact we are painting these separate, right? This is the front axle, already bent and dechromed as you saw earlier, and this is of course the rear axle, which is already, you know, in this case I had to go with bents. All right, we had to cut the tubes at an angle, and again, it's all part of the story, right? Now, the other thing I was going to bring up is that that's one way to make the vehicle look kind of futuristic, right? I'm leaving the engine in because that's the beauty of the Roadster. right? So you could see the way that the engine works, etc., etc. Most of the gizmology is going to go on the on this part, right? We already have the chassis, the frame, with some parts that we want to make sure, and that's why we glue them while they're still naked primer, because once the plastic melts, you get an amazingly strong bond, and that part is not going to move, that part's not going to move, right? So we've got that going. The other thing that we found in the parts box that I think is going to give this build basically our stylistic touch is this thingy here from that we got from another kit, a truck perhaps, and it is going to go, and I was amazed at how perfectly well it fits, and so we just added the bucket lights, and we are going to attach it to the frame, and then we're gonna, you know, once we paint it and glue it on there, we'll add some other details like wires coming out for the lights, etc., etc. So that's where it's at. It's not gonna really have that much other than underneath with the the cables looping and all of that and the stuff connected to the boosters. It's gonna be really a roadster, but you know, between the paint job and the extra details, this should look the part. And also the our floating base, which we still have to build, but that'll be another video and another fun video to watch. Anyway, so stay tuned in for more Cranky Show coming right up, my friends.